Hello, my name is Georgina Tate. I've been here at Trinity almost a year. I'm a CNA. I've been doing this for 23 years. My hobbies are, I like to do all my natural products, like creams and the different products I do, and I like to make my own products, like lamps and things like that. I just like to do everything myself by hand.
So how did you get into that?
It's just something I always wanted to do, so I just started researching and just started making my own stuff because I'm into massage therapy, so, and I want to do more natural things and then stuff that I wanted, and at the time I couldn't afford it, so I went and bought things to make on my own. Natural products like creams and the different products I do, and I like to make my own products, like lamps and things like that. I just like to do everything myself by hand.
So how did you get into that?
It's just something I always wanted to do, so I just started researching and just started making my own stuff because I'm into massage therapy, so, and I want to do more natural things and then stuff that I wanted, and at the time I couldn't afford it, so I went and bought things to make on my own. My son, I have one son. He's 18. He graduated from early college, Isaac Bear. He's a very hard worker, just like me. I try to set examples for him so he will always strive to work harder and harder to get to his goals and his achievements in life. My husband, he's an employee here now. My mom was my biggest influence in my childhood. She was always a hard worker. She was always a God-fearing lady, and she installed that in all of us kids. And today, that's who I depend on, is God. He's always there for me when I don't have anybody else. And one example that she did that always stuck with me when I was smaller and I was in elementary, probably the third grade, and they used to do a lot of parenting, volunteer work there, and so she wanted to be a part of whatever I was doing. So we didn't have a car at the time. And we only had, well, we had one car, but my dad, he would take it to work. And we stayed walking-wise about 10 miles away from my schoolhouse. And when I would get on the bus, she would start out walking all the way to my school just to be there for me.
Mm-hmm. That's amazing. Very special.
I always wanted to, move to the beach. And before my mom passed, she always said, do what's going to make you happy and don't stay stuck in one place. So then that's what really encouraged me to move from Shelby to Wilmington, so, yeah. drive to always do your best and always think of being a leader and not a follower. Making your own direction for your path and try to stay positive at whatever you do, even though it's going to be some negative things that happen. Always stay positive. One in particular, she always tells me, she's like, she always tell me a positive word. She always say, I know you can make it. Keep your head up. Like just encouraging me to just keep doing what I'm doing and things will work out.
And how would you like to be remembered?
As a strong person.